Oh, Clayton,
bro, I got this. I got this board. I guess this is a board, right?
This is a coaching board.
I think this is really possible for us to use in the future videos for more quality content.
Oh,
I didn't see you guys there. Hello, viewers. So, yeah, viewers, right? So we have this coaching board. If you want us to use this board and these fancy magnets in our future videos, don't forget to drop 32 likes for this video.
And comment down below his name for no reason. For no reason at all.
And also play the Halloween theme on this board because it looks really, really cool.
And to make it look cool. Yeah. Let's go.
Right. Okay, so yeah, for future videos, we're probably going to use this. And if you like it, like this content, don't forget to drop a like and also comment down below my name. Yeah.
What's good, people?
Back with me, Claudius Teal.
And me, Clayton Teal.
Today, we have a board, we have some magnets, a marker, and an eraser. So what are we going to do today, Clayton?
We're going to tell you some stuff about man-to-man defense.
Yeah, here we go. So if you guys are wondering what man-to-man defense is, so it is a defensive strategy where a person is assigned or supposed to guard another specific person from the other team. Alright, so for example, in the board here, number 1 is guarding number 1, number 3 is guarding number 3, number 2 is guarding number 2, number 4 is still guarding number 4, number 5 is guarding number 5, even though the ball is here, and also these are the referees, so don't mind them.
So there are two terms in man-to-man defense that is used very often, which is strong side and weak side. To know where is the strong side and where's the weak side, we draw an imaginary line right here that a lot of basketball players use to know which side are they on. Basically, if the ball is on this side right over here, as you can see, this is the strong side and this is the weak side. If the ball is over here, this is the strong side and this is the weak side.
Alright guys, so after Clayton tell you guys about the strong side and also the weak side, we can go to the position, which will be explained later for the corner by Clayton, and I will explain the middle and also the wing. So this is where the ball is. First things first, it's in the middle. So what you want to do is just guard like this, exactly like this. So number 4 and number 5 should make a distance between the one that they guard and also the ball, so they can see both of them. And also this should really kind of, you know, guard or deny in here, so the ball cannot directly pass over here. To add from Clayton's explanation of the strong side, weak side, we can also add another line over here. I'm sorry, it's not really that straight, but you know, this is also like a strong side, weak side. So basically there's like kind of a four section, strong side, weak side, but it's like the horizontal one and also the vertical one over here.
So we haven't really demonstrated on the use of strong side and weak side, so we're just going to demonstrate it right away, right now. Over here, in this case scenario, the ball is right in the middle, so there's no strong side or weak side in terms of left and right, but there's strong side and weak side in terms of top and bottom right over here. As you can see, the ball is at the top right over here, so the players, the defenders at the bottom, 4 and 5, is going to take a distance from the player that they're assigned to guard to. And the players like 3, 1, and 2 is going to be very close with their opponents since they are in the strong side. So to make it easier for you to understand strong side and weak side, we need to know this term called one pass away. As you can see over here, 3 and 2 is one pass away from 1, as you can see over here. And 4 and 5 is not one pass away from 1. This is one pass away basically. And for number 4 and number 5, they need to give distance towards their opponent, because 4 and 5 right over here is not one pass away from 1.
Alright, so guys, Clayton have shown you the position. If the ball is at number 1 right now, we're going to move it to number 3 or number 2. So this is the wing. So the ball is here, which means it's one pass away from number 4 and also one pass away from number 1. While these two defenders over here should make distance, as Clayton said before about the one pass away thing, from their opponents, of course, make a distance like that. boom. So while number four here, before that, if the ball is here, number four is still here. But when number one passes to number three or the wing, number four need to guard closely since this is one pass away. Same thing as the other side. Let's move it over here. So which means this is the strong side and this is the weak side. So we can guard closely, guard closely, guard closely. Why? Because it's one pass away, as Clayton have said before too. And number four and number three is the weak side, so they need to create distance.
So Khalid's already told you the positioning of the defenders. If the ball is on the wing right over here, number three or number two, now we're going to move it downwards to the corner, number four and number five. If the ball is in the corner right over here at number four, that means number four needs to guard him very closely because he has the ball. And the only person that's one pass away from number four is number three. That means this guy has to guard this guy really closely, as you can see. And these people are not one pass away. That means they need to keep their distance. Number five could be here, number two could be here, and number one should keep distance right over here. This works the same for number five right over here. If it's over here, that means he needs to guard closely, number two needs to guard closely, and these people need to keep distance.
This is one tip or like a fact about man-to-man. So this defense over here, if there's like a situation where three and number one, or like three screen one and like just go like that, bringing the ball, you can actually switch. So one can defend three and three can defend one like this. And just like if he passed the ball here and then resets everything and this would be switched. However, if the small man switched with the big man, that would be a different case. So, for example, let's just reset everything back. Imagine this guy is a big man and also this guy is a small man. So the guard will be a big man, small man. So if the small man, if the big man screened the small man over here, and he's gonna go here and then they're gonna switch. Wait, let me get rid of this. They're gonna switch and then the offense, which is the big man, have a mismatch with the small man over here. This would be dangerous. So what you can do is directly switch back, or before switching, hold on, before switching, after screening, you can directly just show up like this, just kind of like stop the dribbler, the one who's handling the ball over here, and just go back to defense normally.
So I'm going to give you guys this one tip right over here. If the ball is on number four right over here, as four needs to guard closely, of course, and number five and number two is far away from number four and far away from the ball, so it needs to add distance from its opponent so that they can guard number four if he drives to the rim right over here. This is only maybe it's only illegal in NBA or other specific leagues since there's a defensive 3-second violation, but if there's no defensive 3-second violation, then this is best for you to do.
Alright guys, thank you so much for watching our video about man-to-man defense. And before anything else, don't forget to do these three things: like, subscribe, and also press that notification button. But before that, you can comment down below for any suggestion for future videos, and whether you enjoyed this video or our previous videos.
And if you don't understand some of our explanation, you can just ask right there in the comments, we will reply.
Yeah, and also don't forget to press that notification bell so
that you will get notified for every video that we will be posting every Friday, 5 p.m. GMT plus 7. Thank you guys for watching. Stay lit, people. So Kogo,
So Kogo,
no.